sit at home order, which some people are complying with. This order is affecting our economy, and our state economy. And we will not allow it to continue. And I'll be taking some far-reaching measures to ensure that that doesn't happen, so that my people can go about their business. You know, banks can go about their work. Transporters can go about their business, market people, everybody. You know, things are tough. And we should look back to the tough times by heeding to, you know, calls that are not economically progressive. You know, if you estimate the quantum of losses already accrued for these orders of sitting at home, you will appreciate majorly what impact is having on the domestic products of the state. It is not something that we are going to allow to continue. And I'm sure you all have your targets as bank branches to meet, and you cannot meet those targets if you continue to do what you're doing. You know, so I'm here to first listen to yourselves why you choose to comply with the other. Some of the answers are obvious. 7 years and a half plus, there was never an armed robbery incident in Anambra State. Never. True or false?
In fact,
I'm asking you guys, true or false? Yes. We've never had an armed robbery incident. Never. Why is this so? Before I came, you all knew how you close your go to the then I was executive director of the Fidelity Bank, in charge of business banking. I know fully how the branches here work. You know, they close their front door and you know, walk from the back. We're not going to go into those kinds of things because the circumstances have not warranted that. This Monday, all your branches must open. All branches must open. Any branch that is not open, we are going to seal that branch, and for the rest of the week, that branch will not be open. I hope I'm very clear. You must open your branch on Monday. And if the sit-at-home order, you comply with it, that means you did open your branch, then we'll seal that branch for the whole week. Then we'll see what happens to your common day. If you don't still open, we close the branch permanently. The following, there will be significantly improved security around the bank branches and other business entities. Why the Security Council members are here is for you to have some level of confidence that the show of force, the protection you've enjoyed in this state since I became governor, and you normally go about your business without fear, you know, you will continue. The transporters will also ply on the roads. The markets will also open. You know, so you don't have any reason not to open your shop. We give you all the necessary protection to make sure that you don't lose your property or anything of the sort. Effective 13th September, which is Monday, you must open your branches.
Let me repeat.
Any branch not open, that branch will be sealed, and for the rest of the week, that branch will remain sealed. And if it happened two times, we close that branch permanently. Like I said before, we are going to deploy extra security. We have detachment of army, you know, we are preparing for election. So we have increase in support of increase support by the police. We have many police men here already. Civil defense, army, navy, we have plenty of them now. And you'll be seeing them all around the places. I request that you articulate your bank branches and address and phone number of people to be reached so that we hand them over to the Commissioner of Police. You know, you all understand me. You know, they will take appropriate positions in strategic locations to ensure that people move about without molestation.
Thank you.